at about the 40-yard line. Didn't shoot bothered by this Panther defensive unit. Let's see if they give him his forward progress. If they do, he picked up 3 yards. If they don't, he lost about 5. They do give him forward progress. That's going to bring up a 3rd and 13. The early going is very rough for the Gordon Longhorns. 3rd and 13, an incomplete pass on 1st and 15, and there the toss is signed for. And he picks up just 2 yards, so the Longhorns go into the spread formation with Garcia at quarterback, signed for behind him. There's the pitch back to signed for. Now he can run with it or throw. Looking for someone, has a receiver, number 22 for Gordon, who takes it to the 30-yard line, now comes back across the field, and he'll have the first down. He may have fumbled the ball, but it indicates it's going to be recovered by the Longhorns. That's Jake Cowder on the receiving end of that pass that Jason signed for, and that's the first down for the Longhorns in this ballgame on their initial offensive series. And if you're just joining us, it's just under 7 minutes to go in the first quarter, 12-0 with Harrell, as they scored on their first possession, then recovered an onside kick and scored again. From the spread formation, there's the snap back to Garcia. He has the sideboard looking for someone. Throws to Garcia. He has it at the 20 down the right sideline. Knocked out of bounds at the 12-yard line. I love that formation. We have a back to the quarterback, pitch back with the running back. The quarterback goes out for a pass. I just think that is a great way to run the football team and throw everybody off. Nobody knows what the heck is going on in the backfield. And you get your best athletes in action every single time.
Well, when you have the athletes that the Gordon Longhorns do, in terms of Jim Costilla, Jason Sizemore, Jesus Tocarina, Levin, and others, you're able to do that kind of formation. Now from the tight formation, here we go. Costilla pitches back to Sizemore, trying to pick his way up the middle of the field. He does, to the 6-yard line. That should be enough for another first down, so it's going to be first and goal. Actually, they mark it at the 7-yard line, so first and goal for the Longhorns. And listen to this crowd.
Jason Sizemore just 3 yards rushing. That was his first rush of the ballgame. A couple yards catching. It's really the most of his actions so far throwing the football.
First and goal as Garcia has him again in the tight formation. Levin in the backfield. He gets the handoff up the middle. Isn't he? No! John Levin!
Unbelievable. John Levin is such a big kid, a great football player. He's powered to going in for a 7-yard touchdown. That's the kind of offense you want in six-man football right there. Excellent blocking by this Longhorn offensive unit. And you had to believe that the Panthers were expecting Sizemore or Costilla to keep the ball. But it's Levin who goes in for 6 points. And now Sizemore will try to tack on 2 more with the extra point conversion. The snap is down. The kick is up. And you can tell by the crowd that it is good. So with 5 minutes, 48 seconds to go in this first quarter, we have a new score from the Mustang Bowl in Sweetwater, Texas. It's Quinn Harrell 12 and Gordon 8. We will return in 60 seconds. Very quick, but I tell you the difference between these two offenses right now. Gordon, a very nice conservative offense, driving down the field with Harrell, has done some big plays so far. Probably the biggest play in the football game was an offside kick so far in the game now. And let's see if Whit Harrell can put a good drive together and drive down the field on Gordon. Let's see what Gordon can do on defense.
First and 15 from the 20-yard line. Has to move it on the line of scrimmage. There's a toss out left. We have a flag, and number 11, Whit Harrell, gets out of one tackle, and now up to the 32-yard line. That's Justin Streichner. He was on the passing end of the 25-yard touchdown pass a little bit earlier to Seth Dockery. I think we're going to have some movement either on the Gordon side of the football or maybe some motion against Whit Harrell. Let's see what the officials come up with on this one. It's going to be an offside call against Gordon, so obviously Whit Harrell will decline it, and perhaps he ran into the cadence of the Panther quarterback. But in any case, that's at least the third time that I can think of that the Longhorns have been drawn offside. Kind of a little six-man state championship dinner. Second and 3 now. There's a handoff up the middle. Breaking out of one tackle and falling forward to the 38-yard line is number 34 for Whit Harrell. That's Justin Sullivan. He will have enough for the first down. They will mark him at the 38-yard line. 5.5 minutes to go in this first quarter in what is already proving to be an exciting ball game for Sweetwater. Spread formation, there's the toss back. Now back across the field to number 15, Jason DeGravani, and he is knocked out of bounds at about the 38-yard line. They may give him the 37, a pickup of just a few, and it's going to bring up second. Actually picked up at about 5 yards. So far, Whitherell, there's been a lot of things that are confusing Gordon defensively. Let's see what they do here with the spread formation again. There's the snap back to Lopez. He's looking for someone. Hunter Throws his intended receiver inside the Gordon 30 at the 28-yard line. That was number 21, Seth Dockery, who was on the receiving end of the touchdown pass earlier. But that time, Lopez just threw that one a little bit short. So the clock, we stopped at 5 minutes 15 seconds to go. More importantly, we have got a third and a long hit for Whitherell. They seek to convert just inside Gordon territory at the 37-yard line. There's a snap back to Lopez. He moves it back to Rogers, trying to give Rogers the blocker. You can hear the roar of approval there for Chris Chamberlain, number 35, who was on the defending end of that one. And that's actually going to be a loss of about 4 yards. And so Whitherell goes into what we would think would be a punting situation as the ball is inside their territory now at their own 39-yard line. Remember, of course, in six-man football, the 40 is the midfield strike. So the ball is at the 39, and indeed, they are going into a punting formation. No one back to receive the punt for Gordon. There's the kick, end over end, heading towards the left sideline, and it goes well out of bounds. Let's see where they mark it. They're going to mark it at the 25-yard line, so that punt, actually, they're going to mark it at the 27-yard line, so that punt carries 14 yards. So this Gordon Longhorns defense has risen to the occasion, giving the ball back to their offensive unit in a pretty good field position at the 28. You know, Lynn, one interesting part about these offenses, they work a lot on improvisation. You get the football, look around, there's a lot of waiting, there's a lot of chipping going on, and really a lot of things happen just because they happen to not only play them that way. So C11 and size 4 in the backfield. There's a handoff around the right side. 11, he's got some room, breaks out of one tackle at the 35, and falls forward to the 38-yard line. Sort of an inside for Bush to get some nice yardage for 11. Looks like they're going to mark him at about the 37-yard line. A pickup of about 10. And so Gordon seems to be perhaps getting rid of a few of those jitters. As we have one of the ESPN cameramen out on the field right now, and he's motioned to back away from Coach Stelz and Campbell. They're trying to focus on their football game. Second and 5, Costilla in the sign formation, has Jesus Tajarina and Sizemore in the backfield. Pitch back to Sizemore. He has some room, but his ankle tackled at about the 40. He really has some real estate down the right sideline. If he could have gotten past one of the Whitherell Panthers, I believe that's number 12, Brandon Rogers, who made a great tackle. It could have been a touchdown saving tackle because we have seen Sizemore move down the sidelines very quickly before. An incredible athlete, been doing all year long for the Gordon Longhorns, you know. And the Gordon Longhorns do have a lot of weapons, 11 Sizemore Costilla, but I'll tell you what, Sizemore is the brightest one. Third and a long three. There's a handoff, 11 up the middle. He has the first down and more. Wow. Oh, heaven. 265 pounds, man. That's a large man.
I think I just heard some moose calls out there.
I tell you, he could pass for the moose. In fact, I think he probably outweighs Gerald Johnson by a few pounds.
He does.
But in any case, he picked up the first down there. He's not explosive. He is quick, and we may see some of that as the game goes on. The first down there is the ball goes to the 34-yard line. There's a pitch back to Sizemore, trying to find his way around the right side. He's inside the 30 to the 28, and Randy, as you say, Gordon methodically moving the football down the field. Not with a lot of flash or a lot of big plays thus far, but they're doing what Coach Nelson Campbell wants them to do. Calling a pickup of about 6 or 7. and it will break second, or let's call it now.